Hi, this is Sabulaman. In this video, we are going to learn how we can derive the general formula. How we can derive the general formula. Okay. So we know the quadratic equations are in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay. So the process of deriving the general formula requires us, the first step, to make sure that this C, we cross it to the right hand side. Meaning that we're going to have AX squared plus BX is equal to negative C. After that, make sure that the coefficient of X squared is what? It's 1. Meaning that if it's not 1, divide by the same coefficient throughout your equation. In this case, our coefficient is what? It's A. So let's divide by A throughout our equation. What are we having? So when we divide by A, so this and this will cancel. So we are going to have X squared plus B over A, X is equal to negative C over A. When you reach at this stage, look for the half of B over A. Half of b over a and you square it. So let's add half of b over a. So we have written this is here, plus half of b over a is the same as multiplying b over a times 1 over 2. Because 1 over 2 simply means half. So we are going to have b over 2a. And then don't forget to square it. So whatever you add on the left hand side must be added onto the right hand side for the equation to be balanced, or for the equation to be conservative as the first one. So we are going to add b over 2a this side, minus c over a, okay? So from here, let's just take x and b, x plus b over 2a, we square them. X plus b over 2a, we square them, is equal to b squared, it's b squared, 2a squared, it's 4a squared minus c over a. From here, notice that when we expand this, we are going to have this statement. When we expand this, we are going to have this statement here. Okay, so this and this, they are absolutely the same. All right, so for us to eliminate the square, what we do, we introduce the square root both sides. We introduce the square root both sides, and then don't forget possible negative. The square root and the square will cancel out. Meaning that, what are we remaining with? We are remaining with x plus b over 2a is equal to possible negative. And then from here, what we are having is this. Inside the square root, we are having a fraction, of which we can look for the lowest common denominator, which is 4a squared. 4a squared divided by 4a squared is 1 times b squared, it's b squared, minus 4a squared divided by a, it's 4a times c, it's 4a c. That's what we are having here. Now, since this is a square root of a fraction, we can separate the square root. So we can separate the square root in this manner. We have got x plus b over 2a is equal to possible negative. The numerator will have its own square root. The denominator will have its own square root. That is, we have separated it. Okay. Now let's simplify our denominator since we can look for the square root of 4a squared. And then let's also make x the subject of the formula by making b over a come to the right hand side. Okay, so when we do this, what are we having? We are having x is equal to b over 2a will become negative b over 2a, positive or negative. Then we have got b squared minus 4ac over the square root of 4 is 2. The square root of a squared is n. So this is a fraction. This part is a fraction. This part is a fraction. Though we are having positive or negative here. Okay? From here, let's look for the lowest common denominator of these fractions. the lowest common denominator of these fractions, which is what? 2a. 2a divided by 2a, 2a divided by 2a is 1, 1 times negative b is negative b. Or simple negative, 2a divided by 2a is 1, 1 times our numerator is b squared minus 4a squared, the square root of course. So it's the square root of b squared minus 4ac. So from this, we have made x the subject of the formula. We should note that the oversign is starting from here up to here, up to the end, not just below the square root, no. It's from here up to here. So this formula is what we are calling the general formula. It's what we are calling the general formula. So in this video, we have discussed on how you can derive